Hey everyone, welcome to Indefatigable Learner. So today in this video, we are going to learn about the elasticity and what are the daily life application of this particular topic. So let's quickly go through the why we should listen to this topic and why should we watch this video and how exactly elasticity is relevant in our life and related to our daily life. So let's go through this question. Why India is facing economic slowdown these days? After that, you'll be able to understand the relevancy of elasticity. Now, as you know that these are the three reasons behind this this economic slowdown, that GST and demonetization and monsoon impact. These are the three reasons what happened after the trade war began and GST was started in India. There was a decrease in demand as the tax rates increased because of the trade war, and that GST was not known, that people were not aware about it. So they decreased the demand for the products, and that decrease in demand led the market to decrease monetary flow. And what happened because of the demonetization? People were not able to get their income on time, and that decrease in the income, or people were not getting income, that affected income led again the decreased demand, and that led to the decreased monetary flow. Now third one reason is the monsoon impact. What happens every year because of the monsoon? When monsoon is late or there is drought, there is flood, so that affects the crop and that affects the farmers growth of the crop. Okay, so that decreases the supply, the input of the commodities, and that lets the market again in the global situation of decreased monetary flow, and that lets the market to a global economical slowdown, a low economic growth. That is nothing but the economic slowdown. Now what is this? After this particular three things change, okay, these three things led the market to the change in something else, or that three things, you can say that these three things led to the change in these three things. Okay, so there is this elasticity. What happened when there was change in the market condition? When I changed the market condition, that I changed the market condition, how I changed, I decreased the supply of the money, I decreased the supply of the commodities inputs, so that change the buyers and sellers respond, or how exactly buyers decreased their demand and sellers decreased their supply. So how this things matters because of the change in the market situation and condition, and that can be the determinants as well. Okay, that we can say the determinants of these three things. Okay, these three things. So I think this is clear. Let's go through the elasticity. After that, we'll be doing with the examples, the daily life relevancy of the elasticity. Elasticity is the measurement of proportional change of an economic variable in response to change in another. If let's take example of Coca-Cola. What happened? Let's say in the year of 2016, the price in the year of the 2016. Coca-Cola decided to increase its price, okay, by rupees $3. Okay, then they just made this $2 increment in the Coca-Cola. Okay, then what happened? People were buying five bottle of Coca-Cola when it was $1, but by the time the price increased and it became $3, they said forget it, I don't want to buy it because that is out of their budget. So that is the change in the quantity demanded by change in price. Okay, so that is the elasticity. Now there is four type of elasticity. First one is demand elasticity, supply elasticity, and cross elasticity, and income elasticity. These are the four types of elasticity. Let's quickly go through this. First one is elasticity of demand. Elasticity of demand says if there is a change in the one of the variable on which the demand depends, then the quantity demanded will be changed, or that is the responsiveness of the change in quantity demanded as per the change in one of the variable on which demand depends. Now let's go through the graphs. Okay, first one graph is of the inelastic demand. Example for it can be medicine. Let's say a doctor has just advised you to have medicine, and the price of that medicine is increasing. Though what you can do, if you have to buy that much amount of medicine, you can't stop buying medicine. Okay, though the price is increasing. Okay, that is inelastic demand. Now inelastic That is perfectly. But if we are talking about the inelastic demand, then one of the example can be the petrol. What happens every year because of the petrol? Though the price of petrol is increasing, though you have to buy it because you have already bought a car, you have already bought a bike, so you can't avoid using petrol. And though in the long run you can decrease the quantity used as that is the reason why the quantity demanded not decreases that much as proportion to the price increment. Okay, now example for elastic demand can be ice cream. If the price of ice cream is increasing only a bit, though the quantity demanded will decrease a lot. Okay, if let's take the example of perfectly elastic, but though there is no realistic example for it, so let's go ahead. And one of the example for and fifth one condition is of the unit elastic. Unit elastic is like that only. Okay, it is like a proportion. As much as the price will increase, that much will be the quantity decrease. Okay, so that is a very proportional and very ideal situation. Okay, so that is unit elastic. Now let's go to the determinants of the elasticity. First one is substitute. If there is a substitute available in the market, let's take the example of tea and coffee. If the price of tea is increasing, then what we can do? We can avoid buying tea, we can start buying coffee because the price of the coffee is lesser than the tea. And let's take the second determinant, that is the income span. Let's say if a person's income is in the higher income is spent on that particular commodity, then he will stop buying it. Okay, let's take the example of meat. If the price of meat is increased, then you will stop buying meat because that is out of your pocket, you can't buy it. Now next one is the complementary between two goods. So first example can be the car and diesel. If the price of diesel is increasing, then what will be happening with the quantity of car? The quantity demanded for the car, it will decrease. Why? Because people will think that no, diesel is out of their pocket. They cannot sustain with it. Okay, the price of diesel is higher, so they will decrease or they will not buy a car. Now, section one is the time and elasticity. Let's take the example of OPEC. If price of a particular oil is increased, okay, it is hugely increased, so he will not buy that particular fuel in a long while. Okay, though you can't in a short run, you can't just stop buying petrol because that is not sustainable. That is not possible. Okay. And that's the reason why you will just stop buying fuel in a long while, but not in a short while. Okay, that is a long run and short run effect of OPEC. Next one is the price of product. Let's say if you are buying Kit Kat, but the money that is needed to buy a Kit Kat, it is much more higher than what you can do, you will just stop buying Kit Kat. Now, sixth one is the luxury or necessity. If something is luxury and something is necessary, let's say the luxury thing can be any car, any luxury painting. If the price is increased, then you will stop buying it. But if it is necessity, then you have to buy it, like milk. If a child needs milk, you can't avoid buying milk. Though the price is higher, you have to buy it. That is the necessity. Okay, I think it is clear to you. Now let's quickly go through the elasticity of supply. Elasticity of supply says it is the responsiveness of the producer to change in one of the variable on which the supply depends. Let's take the example. Good example of, and let's after that graphs, we can just go through the example. First one is the elasticity, where the elasticity is zero. So this is the particular example of perfectly inelastic supply. Okay, let's take the example of a painting. Okay, painting. If a price of a painting, let's say Mona Lisa, her painting price is increasing a lot, though a supplier can't think, no, I should make more and more paintings of Mona Lisa. This is not possible because people are buying this painting because it is antique. Okay, so though the price of that particular painting is increasing, you will not increase the supply for the painting. Okay, now second one is the situation of, next one is perfectly elastic. If let's say the example of cookie, if the price of cookie is increasing, though it is an unrealistic situation, there is no any realistic example, but cookie is considered as a good example for perfectly elastic good. Okay, so if the price of cookie is increasing a lot, then what happened? Supplier will think, why shouldn't I make more and more cookie to earn more and more profit? Okay, so that he will do. Next one is of the unit elastic supply. Unit elastic supply is like, let's say price of the product is increasing a bit only, then he will increase the quantity supplied for that particular cell phone a bit only. So that is a Chinese product. Okay, this is considered as a unit elastic product. Next one is the elastic supply. The example of it can be the pizza. If the price of pizza is increasing only a bit, or let's say price of a pizza is increasing, then what exactly the producer will do? He will just increase the quantity supplied for that product a bit. Okay, now next one is of the inelastic good, that is antique pen. So what will happen if the price of the pen, antique pen, is increasing? Then the supplier can increase the some quantity of antique pen supply, but he cannot make it in a very general sense. If he will make the pen in a huge amount to earn more profit, it will not be an antique pen no more. Okay, it will no more be an antique pen. That's why he needs to keep that antique pen in a very limited amount, so that it is an antique one. Okay, now let's go through the determinants of supply: time period, ability to store output, change in marginal cost of production, excess supply, availability of infrastructure, agriculture or industrial product. These are the determinants of supply. If you have any doubt with this determinants, then do mention it on the comments section, so that I'll be answering it in a very quick manner with some examples. Now, income elasticity. Income elasticity says it is the responsiveness of quantity demanded or supplied for a good as per the change in the income. If a person's income is decreasing or increasing, then what will be the change in his demand and supply for the particular good. Now there are this determinants. First one is as per the nature of the goods. Let's say if a person's income is increasing, okay, then he will stop buying inferior goods such as kerosene oil. He will just start buying some of the good oil, so that he will avoid buying kerosene. Okay, he will start using gas. Okay, LPG, and he will think, no, I have a higher income, now why should I buy the inferior goods? Now next one is the normal goods. Let's say the biscuit, if the income is increasing, what he will do? He will just increase the quantity demanded for the biscuit. Let's say he was eating only 2 packets of biscuit when his income is less. Now his income is higher, what he will do? He will just buy 4 packets of biscuits. Okay, now next one is the luxury good, hotel. If a person's income is increasing, what he will do? He will just start living in the luxury hotels. Or if his income is decreasing, then what he will do? He will just stop using hotels, which is taking the hotels, 5-star hotels, so that he can avoid his money. He can avoid the useless use of his money, or he can just maintain the budget. Okay, now next one is the necessity. If his income is increasing or decreasing whatsoever, it not matters, because this is a inelastic demand. Okay, so he has to buy that medicine and that drugs, okay, because it is a necessity for him. Now next one is the cross price elasticity. It is nothing but the change in the market as per the complementary or the nature of the goods, like substitute or complementary. Okay, so if there is the change in the demand and supply, okay, for one of the good, to change in the price of the related good when these are either substitute and complementary. Okay, let's take the example, the tea and sugar. If there is change in the price of sugar, then what will happen? Then the price of tea will also increase, because it is the input and it is the complementary good. It is needed in while we are making the tea. We need the sugar, we need the So tea and sugar are the complementary goods. Okay, now so these are the reasons of cross price elasticity. Now let's go to the substitute goods. Now Air India and Indigo. Let's say the price of Indigo Airways is increasing. Then what will happen with the quantity demanded of the India Air India? What will people do? As the price of the Air India will be affordable for them as compared to the Indigo Airlines, they will increase the quantity demanded for Air India ticket. Okay, so this is the substitute effect of the goods, and this is the cross price elasticity. Now let's go to the example. Good example was there in the Hindu, when there was this article on our automobile industry and the economical slowdown. So what happened? As we can say that the income, people are not getting their income on time, that's why this particular car and bike is not affordable for them. That's why their income is decreasing. That's why they their quantity demanded is also decreasing. Okay, and here is this mistake. Okay, yeah. So there is this income elasticity and demand elasticity from the supplier side. Okay, so I think this is clear to you that the price of that particular car is as much as it is, but the quantity demand is affected because there is this change in the one of the determinant of the demand on which the elasticity or on which the quantity demanded depends. Okay, this is clear to you. Now let's go to the third example, that is the BS3 vehicle. What happened after there was this ban on the BS3 vehicle by the Supreme Court? The price of the car or bikes were decreased because there was a deadline given to the suppliers. Till that date, the suppliers could sell their bikes. Okay, so all the supplier, they decreased the price of the BS3 vehicle, and after that there was increase in the bikes, BS3 vehicles. Okay, so that was the reason why the quantity demanded affected, and there was this demand elasticity. Okay, I think this is clear. Now let's go through this example of Jio. As the price of the Jio that decreased, the quantity demanded for the Airtel that also decreased. So there is this cross price elasticity and an effect of substitute goods. Okay, these are the substitute in the market. That's why the Jio's revenue is increasing and the Airtel is getting loss. I think this is clear to you, and if this is so, then do mention it in the comment section if you have any doubts. And thanks for watching. Do like, share and subscribe. Bye.